comes John Mauceri to conduct Act One of Bellini's Norma.
Thank you. pur la moglia, io mer far non senta. Va nel mio cuore spenta, la prima fiamma, e un dio la spense, un dio nemico al mio riposo. Ai piedi vecco l'abisso aperto, e lui va dentro io stesso. Altra avresti tu, guarda sommesso, un'altra sì, Adalgisa, tu la vedrai. Or d'innocenza e riso di candore d'amor. Ministra il tempio di questo dio di sangue, alla battare, come raggio di stella, in ciel curvato. Misero amico, e amato sei tu del pari, io no fidanza, e l'ira non temi tu di arma, atroce, orrenda, me la presenta il mio rimorso estremo. Un sogno a narra, in rammentarlo, io
thank you. fino a quando pressi ne vorrai tu quanto me late assai quanto le fate assieme e i tempi abiti dall'aquile latine mai li prendo faziosa non può starsi la
spada
Thank you. Thank you.
Norma grasps Pollione's arm and forces him to leave. He storms off. She takes a dagger from Oroveso to kill who? The end of Act One, with plenty head of steam for Act Two. This is Scottish Opera's production of Norma. Jane Eaglen as Norma, Katherine Ciesinski as Adalgisa, Stefano Algieri as Pollione, Norman Bailey as Oroveso. The conductor is John Mauceri. The orchestra's taking its bow. And we're going to Act Two of Norma now.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Ferro, il 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 fer Thank you.
In death, a nobler, eternal love will begin. Pollione's words as they die. It's a punishment not just for breaking vows of priesthood, but for the hopeless entanglements of love. The incredible last scene of the opera. It's a denouement which leaves the questions for Adalgisa and the two children unanswered, and no one has yet has thought of writing a sequel. Recent events have shown only too clearly that real people still think of fire as a solution for faith. Tonight's performance of Bellini's Norma has been broadcast from the Theatre Royal in Glasgow. Scottish Opera's production was by Ian Judge, designed by John Gunter, and the conductor was John Mauceri. The chorus was trained by Stephen Harris, and the orchestra was led by John Doig. Now the principal singers are taking their curtain calls. Flavio, the centurion, is Richard Coxon. Clotilde, Norma's confidant, is Catherine Crawl. Oroveso, Norman Bailey, looking properly like a chief druid. Adalgisa next. This is Katherine Ciesinski, in real life Norman Bailey's sister-in-law. He's married to her sister, the singer Christine Ciesinski. Pollione, Stefano Algieri, the tenor, has taken his call. And here comes the protagonist herself. You can hear the applause for her. And one of the great female roles in Italian opera, as Norma Jane Eaglen. Well, you can't do Norma unless you have a singer who can really sing that main role. And Scottish Opera have done wonderfully well with Jane Eaglen. The singer's now lining up to take her call together. I don't see the two boys. Perhaps they've gone home already. You didn't hear them sing, but they certainly added something to their scene. expecting John Mauceri for his call now. Jane Eaglen's going to bring him on. I'll tell you meanwhile that the production was put on in association with the Peter Moores Foundation. John Mauceri there bringing the orchestra to their feet. Got a very warm applause all around me. Well, next Saturday, the opera on BBC Radio 3 comes live from English National Opera. It's the new production of Ariodante, which is not, in spite of the way it sounds, an Irish opera, but which may well have been produced here since Handel's story is set in Scotland. It's had some rave reviews, and I know it'll make a good evening's listening. So I hope you'll hear it. From me, here in Glasgow, goodbye.